Hi, I'm Andy Cranston, and I've brought you today to the lovely Viaduct Fishery. And I'm going to give you my 10 top tips for how to catch commercial silverfish. Tip number one is use a dark ground bait, and my mix of choice is two parts F1 dark to one part Thatcher's. It's a tried and tested mix, one I've got so much confidence in, I've caught tons of fish over. Now the reason you want a dark mix is because now we're coming into winter, the water in these lakes is starting to clear up, and feeding a dark mix just means the fish are much happier to sit over the top of it and should result in a lot more bites. Tip number two is I like to mix my ground bait on the damp side for this commercial silverfish fishing. The reason being is that I like to feed it loose. That's due to there being a soft bottom due to all the silt. So I don't want to feed my ground bait in balls. I want to pot it in loose, mixing it up damp. When I put it in, I can turn my pot over and it's going to go down in like a sandcastle and then disperse lovely over the bottom and create a nice area that those skimmers are going to feel comfortable sat over to graze. Tip number three is don't be scared to feed plenty of ground bait, especially on the venues where you're mainly targeting skimmers. Feeding a big hit of ground bait at the start, like four or five loose pots, but with very little bait in, can be a great tactic to get these skimmers comfortable, sat over an area where they're going to be willing to feed and you can pick them off as you go along. Tip number four, start off with a negative approach with your bait. Contrasting to what I've said before, with ground bait, you can be fairly positive with ground bait where skimmers are concerned, but within that, you don't want to feed too many individual particles. Now, the reason for that is if you've got too many particles dotted around your peg, it's just like a needle in a haystack with your hook bait. You're making your job harder for yourself to pick off a fish. With little particles, you can go in with your hook bait and have a much better chance of catching a fish quickly. Tip number five is plumbing up. Now, you need to be really, really accurate when you plumb up on these venues. And what I like to do is I start off on a 30 gram plummet and have a good drop around with peg, really, really drop it down hard and find out what you're fishing on. Find out how soft the bottom is and see if you can find a harder area. And once you've determined what you're fishing on, how soft the bottom is, then you want to put a lighter plummet on, like a 15, 20 gram plummet. Plumb your rig really, really accurately. And what I do is I plumb right to the base of the body of the float. And that is how I plumb my peg up for this style of fishing. Tip number six is give yourself some options. And what I mean by that is set up a few different lines around your peg. The reason for that is on these venues, the fish can get a bit spooky and they can be quite tricky to catch. So you want to catch a few on a line and then move to another one, rest that line before going back and nicking fish from here and there to keep yourself ticking over all day long. Tip number seven is light elastics. Generally, these commercials aren't very deep, sort of 3 to 5 foot deep on average, and the skimmers have got quite a soft mouth where from feeding in the silt. So you want a lighter elastic, because after you're only fishing with light rigs and light hooks, so you want to set the hook, but you want a nice cushioned, soft elastic to play those fish back and make everyone count. Tip number eight is fishing light. Light rigs, light lines and small hooks. These fish can be really, really tricky to catch in the winter, so fining everything down is the best way of tricking them. My rigs are 4x12, anything from 4x10 to 4x14, F1 fines, F1 maggot, 013 power line main line, and down to 08 AccuPower hook lengths and size 20 and 18 SFL hooks. Lovely and light, perfect for tricking a few skimmers. Tip number 9 is get your float dotted right down to a pimple. These skimmers on commercials in the winter, the bites off them can be really, really finicky and very, very hard to see. So you need to make sure that float is dotted down and you see absolutely every indication. Okay, my final tip, tip number 10, is keep ringing the changes. It's important at this time of year that you keep making slight adjustments. These fish can be really, really tricky to catch, and just offering a different presentation, picking a different rig up, changing your hook bait, moving lines, will keep nicking you an odd fish through the match and eventually end up catching more fish than you would have done if you hadn't have just been so one-dimensional. Follow my 10 top tips on commercial silverfish, and it'll help you put more fish like this in your keep net.